Head Start is celebrating its golden anniversary this year. Locally, the Mid-America Regional Council is marking the milestone with a 50 Faces of Head Start exhibit. One honoree is David McGehee.
You know, I don't ever remember having a whole lot as a kid. I had an alcoholic father, a mom that was a waitress in my early days, kind of worked her way toward managing bakeries and grocery stores in Boonville, Missouri. I really think the Head Start program was in a house. That's what I remember. I don't remember it in a building other than kind of a house. And I went to kindergarten with confidence and able to do the things that they were asking me to do. And I loved my kindergarten teacher. I do remember her.
McGehee is hazy on the details, but he believes Head Start prepared him for school.
I graduated high school. I thought, okay, maybe I'll be a teacher because that's the environment I was most comfortable in my whole life. And I'm sure all the way back to Head Start all the way through, that's the most structure I had in my life.
Esther Francis is another 50 Faces honoree. Head Start also influenced her career and helped her kids.
My family's introduction to Head Start was at a perfect time in life. I was unemployed at the time and had decided that was probably as far as I was going to go. Head Start focuses on kindergarten readiness. They really help them focus on social cognitive skills and being able to just play in those different settings helps to prepare them for being in the classroom.
Francis settled on a human resources career through Head Start.
That experience then on the policy council level at Mid-America Head Start was my first interaction with serving on a human resources interview team. And that was really what ignited my career path.
But the program has its critics. They say Head Start benefits fade by the third grade.
I could point you to a number of studies that show that the impacts of Head Start don't wear off. It really is a multifaceted program that is interested in academic outcomes, social emotional outcomes, health outcomes, family outcomes. So it's important, I think, that when we talk about the long-term impacts, that we think about all those different areas.
Health is a key focus of the program.
I think Head Start has always really appreciated how interconnected the areas of development are, and health is a major component.
I truly believe that those health screenings that are provided to the children are very beneficial and almost crucial because there are times that many of the children are not going to have that opportunity otherwise. For instance, the dental program that shows up at the school and the kids are there well taken care of and they're so excited and they come home at the end of the day and they're like, Mommy, I got my teeth cleaned, you know?
Thousands of people out there like me that could go back and whether they remember it or not, have some component of their life affected by Head Start.
Whenever it was threatened, there has always been a grassroots effort, typically led by families who have benefited from Head Start and know the difference that it's made for their children, who've raised up their arms and said, we can't let that happen. We can't let Head Start die.
It's hard to put in a nutshell what Head Start has done for my family. I'm extremely grateful, though.